Hi guys, my name is Bife here from RFN. Welcome to Inside Destiny for the week of the 19th of April. Coming up on the show, we've got big news this week as, sadly, Martin O'Donnell has departed from Bungie. More on that in a second. In the community focus, we have some incredible Nerf guns that are made from Destiny weapons. All this and more, with soon a chance to win a poster this week, Inside Destiny. So, today is a sad day. I never thought I'd be saying these words, but here I am saying them. Martin O'Donnell has left Bungie. Much to my sadness, much to the sadness of the entire community, and much to, well, I think the loss of the games that we'll see out of Bungie in the future. I'll be completely honest, he was a really integral part of a lot of Bungie experiences for me. Halo and a lot of its soundtrack is part of the reason that I stayed in that game for so long. I stayed in Reach and Halo 3 because I was so caught by some of the emotional moments created in something as simple as a menu screen, or as a cutscene, a really good part of the campaign. It's something I really will miss, and if this isn't taken as a serious blow to the game, then I don't know what will be. But enough about that, that's my personal sentiment. What actually happened? Well, first of all, it started March 16th. We took a look on Marty's Twitter, and bam, there's this tweet right here. Essentially, it reads as follows. Martin O'Donnell says that I'm saddened to say that Bungie's board of directors has terminated me without cause on April 11th, 2014. He was evidently unable to announce this for another 5 days of closure. So, what does this mean? Well, it means that whilst he was terminated without being given much real cause, he most certainly did nothing wrong. You see, the difference between terminated without cause and terminated with cause is the fact that if he was terminated with cause, he would have done something such as broken the law or done something that had been seen as poor conduct by the company. So this is most certainly not anything that is seen as wrong. In response to this, on the same day, Deej made a post talking about how this day would never come, and a lot of us thought this day would never come. The title in that is completely true. And it reads that, for over a decade, Martin O'Donnell has filled our worlds with unforgettable sounds and soundtracks, and left an indelible mark on our fans. Today, as friends, we say goodbye. We know that wherever his journey takes him, he will always have a bright and hopeful future. We wish him luck on all his future endeavors. Now, this is interesting because of the difference between that and the tweet. You see, the tweet is much more aggressive. Martin O'Donnell is saddened that the board of directors terminated his contract without cause. Those two words, terminated and saddened, bring a much different tone from parting as friends. So, really, what is the true story behind here? I do not know, but we can most certainly be sure that Marty didn't break the law or anything. If anything, this is something that's a decision by the Bungie board of directors. Will we actually know what happened? Probably not. It's probably best summed up by DBO, who said that maybe there will be a day when both parties are able to share what happened. But for now, it's just not going to happen. We're not going to find out anything. And one thing I would state is that rampant speculation is most certainly not helpful at this particular point. I've seen a lot of rumors out there from Reddit users to NeoGAF users, some claiming to be Bungie employees, some claiming to know what happened. Don't believe a thing you hear. Only from Bungie.net and trusted sources. Also of note is the fact that there was an interview with Marty done by the guys over at DBO. It was rather lengthy, and this happened immediately after he got, well, essentially announced that he was removed from the company. And his words were mainly positive. He has a lot of good stuff to say about Destiny in this interview. Most importantly, though, he tweeted that his audio director role being moved on to someone else and being removed from him is not going to impact the final piece of Destiny. The music is already done, predominantly. The majority of the stuff that we have in the game is going to be his. And apparently it's very easy to replicate a sound that one composer has made and make it very easy while still adding your own personal tweaks. So we may not have lost as much as we think we have, although the fact that these scores that we had in Halo and Marathon over all these years were evolving scores, scores that added on previous layers of depth, the fact that we've lost Marty at the very beginning of this means that it's going to go in a completely unintended direction from what it originally was, and I think that is a downside in a sense, because it's not got the same flair. Of course, Marty and Mike and in this particular case, Paul McCartney were also working on the project that was titled Music of the Spheres. Now, Music of the Spheres is something he hasn't been able to comment on, sadly, but it is a standalone piece, and eventually it is going to come out. And really, it's something that we'll be able to hear in a few months, but it's nothing we'll be able to hear now, and Marty isn't giving us any early drops. He also couldn't comment again on why he had been dropped from this DBO interview because, well, you know, he's still under NDA with this, I'm sure. This is just a really sad day, I don't know how else to describe it. This is a man who is a veteran of the industry, and I think I say for everyone that everyone is a little bit shocked, you know. There is nothing that we can really do to help our situation in this, we just sort of have to deal with it. Move on, and well, really just roll with the punches, I suppose. It's a sad day for Destiny. The future will continue without Marty. Destiny will release on September 9th without any future input from him. His music is already in the game, it's already ready. And right now, we are honestly just waiting to see how this affects Bungie in the future. But for what it's worth, thank you, Martin O'Donnell. Thank you for everything that you've contributed to the games that have come out of Bungie in the years. And thank you for your continuous effort in the creation of glorious music that has inspired everyone in this community. Day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year. You, in our hearts, have become a legend. So, on a somewhat cheerier note this week, the community is still full of stuff, and it's got some incredible offerings this week. Let's start out, first of all, with Nerfenstein's offering this wonderful piece of cosplay gear right here. This is a weapon that is modeled after various things in Destiny. It's an LMG of sorts, but it also comes with another hunter knife. We've seen many of these out there, but this is probably one of the better ones I've seen, more detailed. It even has all these lovely little paint job elements to it, like how one part of the blade is more sort of worn down than the other. I love that kind of stuff. Next up, we have cookie cutters. Yes, I'm not kidding, this is now a thing. Destiny cookie cutters, guys. For those of you who bake, I sort of bake, but I'm still not going to make Destiny cookies. I don't know. So yeah, these wonderful little babies were made by Francesca for me on Etsy.com. I'll see if I can link this. Maybe I can, maybe I can't. And finally, Cosplay Emerald, or previously known as Unknown Emeralds, has created this awesome Titan cosplay, complete with Duke Mark 44 and FWC painted fusion rifle. I'm not sure how one describes this business, but basically it looks damn cool. Like, wow, the fact that we have cosplay for Destiny already, I've said this before, but it's incredible. It really is. I do not really expect this kind of stuff when it comes to a AAA game that has not been released yet. It's really mad to see this stuff happening. So that sums it up for this week, guys. I really do still want to hear your thoughts on everything that's happened with Martin O'Donnell, though. Please do tell me what you think in the comments below. I'm going to bring back posters next week, so go ahead and continue watching these videos. Do still like and favorite these, and soon you may still be winning a poster. I really do look forward to giving those out again. It's one of my favorite parts to all of this show. And yeah, I really still am kind of shocked, so please do remember to comment on that stuff. In the meantime though, guys, do also remember to like this video, favorite it if you really did enjoy the content that I gave out here. I work a lot every single week on Inside Destiny, as well as all my other Destiny content that I do out there in the community. And you know what? I think it's really appropriate that on top of that you follow my Twitter, because it has all of these hilarious ramblings that I get every single day. In particular, did you know that I managed to find some way in Minecraft to create a floating head? I know. Find out how on my Twitter, or at least see it. Either way, that's not important. The important thing is, my name has been, my name is Bife. I'm signing out here, Guardians, and do remember, this week we have lost a great one. But do things to honor his name. Do not leave it in darkness with actions of hatred. Per audacia astra, I'll see you, Starside.